Hello everyone, feel warmly welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to launch and play My Hero Academia on PC. As you can see now, you are watching it on your screen. It takes almost no time to simply download and install My Hero Academia and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and large monitor. Then without further ado, let's go my friends. First of all folks, the first thing to do is to open our favorite internet browser. We have here the one we use by default. Let's go to the next URL I'm highlighting in green. There you are seeing it on the screen. There is no need to type anything, because there's the clickable link in the description of this video and the first pinned comment. We arrived here on the website of Usitility, exactly where we get an in-depth description on the best way to download My Hero Academia on PC. We browse down a little bit and click on the Download Game on PC button. Once we click on the link, we arrive here on the website of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we will run to play My Hero Academia on the PC. As you can see here, we access several pros of preferring using the emulator. Then, we will start downloading the My Hero Academia by clicking on the button Play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green color. We then click on the button, and the download takes no time at all. Here it is. This is the download. It's a file we have to execute. What we are going to do is to run the installer, okay, so we click on this file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to make modifications to the device. We answered yes. I reduce the browser to find the installer better. The installer is very simple. It contains two choices, install, and setup path. I am going to talk about what setup path does. We basically just click on it. And now we see that we end up with here the path in which the emulator is going to be set up. If we plan to change this folder, we must click on the Browse option. Therefore, we opt for another folder and install the emulator where we desire. To keep it simple, just leave it by default. Then, I click on Back. So I click on Install. Voila! The installation begins and it will carry on together with the download of all these megabytes that happens to be displayed on the computer screen. The time you download it, it might possibly be a little bit more or less megabytes. The data transfer speed might go faster or slower, based on your web access and according to the data transfer rate of the emulator servers. Now they're going superbly fast. The download is done, and right now it proceeds with the setup step. The setup will take a little bit more or less time depending on the power of your laptop or computer. The more efficient it's actually, the faster the installation time and vice versa. If we merge the download and setup phase, it may take quite a while, so be patient. It is now finished on my side. At this moment, the emulator has been started automatically. As you can observe, down here, there's a progress bar that will advance to the right, so when it gets into the end, the emulator is launched for the first time. The fact is the emulator has already been started. Here it is for the first time. Before we carry on, as you can see, it has made two software icons here on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon is going to be the one we are concerned with. The moment we would like to start My Hero Academia on our PC, we double-click on this icon and as a result start the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon is not related to multiplayer or anything such as that. In reality, it's an icon that we will most certainly never ever utilize. Why don't we do the following step, which is a requirement, and that's to begin to browse the Google Play Store. As you can see now, the Google Play is launched. Right here we have to sign in. At this time when we're here, we have to accomplish this next step that is definitely mandatory. So we just click on sign in. At this moment it says checking info. It could sometimes get blocked in checking info, and this isn't going to move forward. If that's the case, you can attempt to log in after a couple of hours and it'll very likely be fixed. At this moment we are going to insert our email and password. The email is required to be a Gmail email as well as its corresponding password. For example, you can utilize the same exact email you're using right now in your YouTube account. Therefore, I am going to insert my information and I will return immediately after I have accomplished it. That's all. Data typed in. Here is Google welcoming us and providing us the twos. We are going to say yes to them by pressing I agree. Following, it offers us to save to the Google Cloud. You can let it check it's going to create a backup of the data on that device to Google Drive. I will not check it. You do what you want. We mouse click on accept. Google Play Store is launched automatically and automatically. To set up the app game, we are required to go to the emulator desktop for Android by clicking on this app icon indicated green colored. Today that we are on the desktop of this emulator, we observe that we now have there the install game option. We click on the button. Right here we have the game app. So let's simply click there on the install link that I'm presenting now in green. Therefore it will start the software installation. At this moment it should install the game. It typically takes a while, or it might well be almost immediate. It again all is subject to on our internet connection. It has actually finished installing. Back to the emulator desktop by clicking on this particular button that I'm presenting in green, that allows you to launch My Hero Academia for the very first time. Let me click on that My Games option proceeding. We're already on the emulator desktop, and we're about to just click on the new My Hero Academia software icon that has been created. This game is started for the first time on your machine. Now there we have it. I can also click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I should comment on the volume level of the emulator. It's here. We use the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume. This manner we will not depend on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of your emulator. As well as to enjoy the experience to the maximum, we can switch on the big screen, for which we have two options. That is the first one, we click on this particular icon which I'm designating in green. Then the screen is maximized, offering one border at the top, one on the right side and one at the bottom. Assuming that we want to run the game in full screen, we hit that icon. And we might at present be enjoying the game app in full screen function. To exit the complete screen mode, press the F11 key. And then we would now be in regular computer screen setting. At this moment I am going to demonstrate you the keyboard mapping that is actually rather appealing. That way we will be in a position to play the game application far more easily. The first thing is to click on this keyboard icon. And here you will be able to get the necessary configuration settings. I am about to put the default settings, but if you want to adjust this, you may very well do this without any problem. As you can notice, the emulator is completely in our own language. Sometimes it happens that the emulator is presented in the wrong language, such as, in Chinese. And therefore to set it in the proper language we browse here to the cogwheel. Then here inside of other options, we simply click on the language drop down. We may very well decide on the language we need, English, Chinese, and so forth. As soon as the language is determined, we are going to save, the emulator would restart, along with the video game, the next time we run it, would also be in the specified language. At present, there is another information that we must take into account, and it is that we will get a message from Gmail telling you that a new device has been associated with this Google account. It will likely check with us if we are the ones who have connected that device. Indeed, we shouldn't get worried, since the emulator is behaving like in Google Android device. In order to see which smartphone or tablet is being emulated, we return here, to the cogwheel and we then click on it. And so we go here to the model choice. And here we determine that the emulator is acting as a Samsung mobile. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for that tutorial. I anticipate you liked it. Specifically that you thought it was useful. If so, allow it a pleasant thumb up, subscribe, and I will be happy to answer your comments, concerns or suggestions, leave them in the comment box below. You also can leave comments on my Twitch channel. I actually do live streams from time to time. You get it listed below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Check out any of those training videos that happens to be appearing on the listing of videos to watch and see you in the future instructional videos. Bye.